Hello beautiful people, my name is Jane and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to talk about loneliness and relationships. Now, there's this notion, there's this idea or expectation that when you're in a relationship, you're not supposed to get lonely anymore, right? Loneliness is supposed to be for single people, for people that are not in the warmth of love. It's supposed to be for those people, not for people that are in a relationship. The truth is, there are people in relationships that are more lonely than people that are single. So that's what we're going to be talking about in this video. Why is it that even being with somebody, even being in a relationship, even being in love, you still get lonely? There's so many reasons why that may be. And if you don't know where your loneliness is coming from, where the root is buried, you're not going to be able to figure out how to get out of it. It's not about being in a relationship. It's not even about love. So now let's talk about some of the things, some of the reasons why people might still get lonely even when they are in a relationship. The first one is, you might be looking for something in somebody that only you can give yourself. You might be looking for love in others, love that others can give you, and neglecting the ones that you can't give yourself. And like I said at the beginning, you have to find out where your loneliness is stemming from, why you get lonely. Why is it that 1 minute is like a content? Have you ever even been content even when you're in a relationship? And so why is it that 1 minute is like, I have everything I need, and then what is it that triggers you? What is it that brings about that feeling of loneliness? If you're able to find out what it is, then you can be able to figure out how to go about fixing it and getting to a point where you're no longer always feeling like you're alone even when you're with somebody. But when I say maybe you're looking for something in others that only you can give yourself, people often underestimate self-love. I'm always saying this thing, people often don't know what it means to love themselves. To love yourself is not only about buying yourself fine clothes, or buying yourself cars, or buying yourself shoes, or even buying yourself material things. It's not just about that. It's being kind to yourself. It's giving yourself room to be you. Is it the way you talk to yourself, the way you love yourself, the way you care for yourself? All those things that you want to do for other people when you're in your relationship with them. Do you ever think of doing those things for yourself? Why do you always feel the need to go on dates only when you're dating somebody? Why do you feel the need to leave a luxurious, maybe not luxurious, but at least a comfortable life, or only when you're with somebody? Are you waiting for something to happen before you become happy? You feel like the reason why you're unhappy right now, or unhappy with yourself right now, is because you don't have a partner yet, you don't have your dream job yet. Loving yourself is a daily thing. It's something you do daily, just like taking a shower, just like eating. It's in your gestures, it's in the things and the little things that you do for yourself. Not putting yourself through unnecessary pain. And when you fall short of your own expectations, being able to forgive yourself. There are people that don't know how to forgive themselves. They can do it for other people, but they can't do it for themselves. All these things, if you're someone that was being courage for yourself, you can't love yourself, you can't stand yourself, you feel like you're not good enough, you're not worth it, you're never going to be content when you're in a relationship. Even the love that people give you will not have meaning. Honestly, you'll not even be able to love people if you don't love yourself. So if you're looking for that in other people, hoping that when you have a full house, this is a question you need to ask yourself today. Am I looking in others for things that only I can give myself? That's number one. Number two, you are with a selfish partner. These people that always put themselves first. If you're not in somebody's priority list and you're in a relationship with that person, and that person is number one on your own priority list, you'll be lonely. You'll be in a relationship and you'll be lonely. If somebody is the prize for you, but you're just an option for them, they will treat you the way they will treat every other person, or you always make the effort to treat them differently than you treat other people, you're going to be lonely, because the love that you're being given is not enough. It's not up to standard, and you always feel like something is missing. And that feeling of something is missing is what will make you lonely. So if you're with somebody and you still feel alone, there's a very high chance that your partner is a selfish partner that has no interest in your emotional needs, in your psychological needs. It's not just about physical needs. Loneliness often stems from the inside. It often comes from the inside, not from the outside. So it's not about material things. It's not about the physical things. It's often about the mental things, the emotional things, the psychological things. That's where loneliness comes from. So if your partner is not with you, does not connect with you on that level, there's a very high chance that you would feel lonely even when you're in a relationship. Number three is, your heart is somewhere else. Most times people decide to be in relationships with other people for for whatever reason. Because they feel like I'll be safer here, or the person they love, they can't have the person they love, and then they go for the next best thing. And often most times that you're with somebody that's actually good and maybe doing their best for you, but because they're not that person, the person, you're still not satisfied, and then you find yourself lonely, which is why it's not always good to be with somebody that you don't love when your heart is still somebody else. So it's better to sort yourself out, sort your things out, make sense of your emotions, of the things that are happening to you before you move on to the next, or before you go into a relationship with somebody else. If you're with somebody, but you're still hung up with your ex, you're still thinking about your ex, you're still stalking him or her on social media, and when you're with somebody else, you'll still be lonely, even with somebody in the house. You've been in a relationship, you still be lonely. And that can be good, because in the process, you might also hurt somebody else that doesn't deserve it. So if your heart is somewhere else, please finish with somewhere else, but you come to another place. Number four is, other areas of your life are in shambles. If you're in a relationship, no matter how good your relationship is, or your career is not going anywhere, you're having issues in your business, a family member that you care about is sick, or maybe somebody that you really care about is sick, no matter how good your relationship is, if these things prolong and there's no effort to fix it, there's no plan to get it fixed, it's going to take a toll at some point in your relationship as well. So that's why you might be with somebody but you're still lonely, because every other area of your life is still empty. No friends, no family, no job, every other part of your life, because it's not just about love and relationship. Relationships are just a fraction, just a little of what makes your life. So if other areas of your life are not, there's a very high chance that you will feel lonely even when you're with somebody. Now, to conclude, the fifth one is, if you find that your loneliness persists, even when you're not dealing with any other thing that I've mentioned in this list, none of them is your problem, but you're still lonely, you might need to go to therapy to find out where your loneliness is coming from. Because most times, I know there isn't much mental awareness going on in this part of the world. Some of these things are not just, some of them are actually medical. You need therapy to be able to help you get past it. And people that have extreme cases of loneliness, even when they are surrounded by people that love them, they can't feel it. So if you're one of those people, no matter how hard you try, you always find yourself feeling isolated, then maybe I really suggest that you try therapy. In many moments, we have access to therapy. Even online, there are so many doctors that are doing a lot of these things, and it will really do a lot of good to get the help that you need to be able to live your best life. Loneliness is a very big issue. The people that do things, most times, they don't know why they do that, but one thing they know is that they always feel alone, and it's not a good thing. They say, man is a social being, man should not be alone, should not feel alone. Have alone time, that's why there's time beside it, alone time. When the time I finish, it's time to do a socialize. So thank you guys for watching this video. Thank you so much for watching it and being here. If there are other reasons why people might feel lonely, you know, in a relationship, please do want to comment and let me know, because I really like to know. Please check out some of my other videos. I have other videos as well that might interest you to watch. Please check them out and give this video a like, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.